Hey friends, as organizations modernize their data estate, they want to explore, prep, transform, train, predict, and serve their data to unlock insights to drive better outcomes, more insightful decisions, and business transformations. Gaurav Malhotra is back once again to show us how to do that on Azure, code-free, and at scale today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Gaurav and we're going to talk more about Azure Data Factory. Welcome back.
Yeah, thank you, Scott.
So you've got a pattern here for me to make things work at scale with Azure Data Factory data flow.
Yes. So what we are doing is that right now organizations are looking to modernize their data warehouse, right? Mm. So we see that customers are looking to ingest data from multiple sources, prep the data, train the data, serve the data so that ultimately they can make intelligent decisions based on that data. Mm-hmm. So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to use a retail scenario of omnichannel customer engagement to show you how organizations are looking to combine data in store and from online sales and provide the best in class customer experience, right? So the first step of doing that is ingesting data into the lake. Okay, so here I am on Azure Data Factory, and this is the modern web-based IDE that you already know that is used to build your ETL or ELT workflows. So this here I have an ingest pipeline where you can see that I'm getting data from different sources. So I have the location data coming in, which includes the in-store beacon data for customers. I have some customer information from Dynamics, products information, point of sale information from SQL, clickstream data coming in from Amazon S3. And I'm ingesting all of that data. These are live data ingestion activities in Data Factory into Azure. Now, if as a customer you want to use any other data set, you can do that in few simple clicks. And here we support 80 plus connectors. We have support for on-prem connectors, like if you're looking for Oracle, if you're looking for SaaS connectors, they're all over here, right? Mm. So you can choose from any of these and ingest data from these connectors into the lake, okay?
Okay.
So now that you have ingested data into the lake, the next step for you is to prep and transform the data. Right.
Okay.
So I have another pipeline over here, which I call as a transform pipeline. And here I'm using a data flow activity. So this is the newly added capability in Data Factory, which allows you to do code-free transformation at cloud scale via Spark execution.
Code-free?
Yes, code-free.
Okay.
So if I double-click this, you'll see that this is the data flow canvas. And here you can see that I'm doing a bunch of transformations. And if as a customer you want to choose any other transformation, you just click the plus and you can choose any of these. If you want to do join, conditional split, lookup, sort, merge, pivot, window transformation.
This canvas keeps getting better and better.
Yes,
it's really amazing.
These are all codeless transformations that we are giving to you, right? So for this particular example, you can see that I'm doing a join over here. So I want to join my sales transactions with account information. And here, I've just selected what type of join I want. Mm-hmm. I've selected the column on the left and the right. And you just have to do this. You can do this in a few simple clicks.
Right.
Right. So now, here as a customer, we are doing all the heavy lifting, right? Because all of these transformations are executed on the big data clusters via Spark, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the job management and cluster management all is taken care by us, right? And you as a customer don't have to do anything because it's all a managed environment.
Amazing, big data as a service.
Exactly, right? So if you think about it, what we are trying to do is that we are trying to democratize big data tools, right? And we are trying to take those to the masses so that they can do two things. A, they don't have to focus on learning Spark, Scala, Java. They can actually focus on the business logic,
right?
The second thing is this gives them longer shelf life for their solutions, right? Because now tomorrow, if a new Spark version comes, we will automatically work to enhance their code to work with the new version. They don't have to do anything, right? So their solutions just keep on working once they code that over here, once they build these data flows and it's always running, right? Okay, so now that we have done the prep and transform of the data, the next step is to load the data into the warehouse, right? And here I'm going to be using Azure SQL Data Warehouse Gen 2, which as you guys are aware, is the fastest and the most performant petabyte scale cloud data warehouse available in the market. I hope everyone read the independent analysis that GigHome did, which actually says that data warehouse is 14 times faster and 94 times cheaper than its other cloud scale providers that provide the cloud data warehouse today in the market.
Wow.
Right? So here with Azure Data Factory data flow, now we have this ability where you can pipe in your final data directly into data warehouse. So we have a sync transformation over here. Mm-hmm. So if you choose sync, and here if I can select let's say I'm going to select a SQL DW.
Okay.
And here now I have a DW available. I can essentially say do upserts, inserts, and support other patterns. I can essentially create tables on the fly. So if my table does not exist in my data warehouse, it will automatically create that. It can truncate the table, recreate the table, as well as it will load the data parallelly using Polybase at scale into your data warehouse, right? So all of that can be done from inside the data flow now, right? So now what we did was we ingested the data into the lake, we prepped and transformed the data, and we loaded the data into the data into the data warehouse. We are ready to now combine all of this together in a data integration pipeline. Right, so I have this data integration pipeline over here. So if I were to just full screen it, you can see that over here, what I have is all my data ingestion activities. Mm-hmm. If they succeed, then I do a data prep. If that runs successfully, I do the sales analytics again using a data flow. If any of it fails, I send a failure email, right? So now, if you are a traditional ETL guy, who does not want to write code and want to do it in a code-free manner that I showed you, you can use it. But if you are a guy who likes writing code, you can do this exact thing by writing code as well. So here in this pipeline, I'm doing the exact same thing, but instead of using the visual data flow, I have a notebook activity where I have written all of the code to do those transformation in the notebook, right? So
Nice. It's
the exact same thing. So totally as a choice for the customer, whether they want to go code-free or they want to write their Python code and have more control. So totally up to them.
That's nice. And this is, again, we've talked about this before when we've had you on Azure Data, on Azure Friday, talking about Azure Data Factory, is you're being prescriptive, but you're not being, you're not demanding that people do it a certain way. So Azure, you know, data guys and gals that want to do it a certain way, they can bring the tools that they want, the connectors that they want, they can do it with code, they can do it with the visual designer, it's just gonna work, mm-hmm. and you don't impose upon them how they have to do their things.
Yes, so it's a choice as a customer that you make whether you want to work with one versus the other.
Yeah.
Okay, so now you have done this, you have built your pipeline, you can use all the visual capabilities that we have available for doing iterative development and debugging. So you could put breakpoints and say that I want to only run up till this. If you want to run this on a cadence or an event, you can put a trigger on top to say, yeah, I want to run this every day, every 15 minutes, or on an event when my file lands in the blob. Mm-hmm. And once you put the trigger, now you can monitor these solutions end to end as well, using our rich monitoring interface. So here you're looking at the monitoring tab in your Data Factory web tool. Every row here is a pipeline run. You can dive deeper into it to look in more details. Mm-hmm. So you can see over here that for copy, you can look at details to see how much throughput you get, how much time it took for your copy to happen, how much time the data was in queue. So all of that details is presented to you. In addition to that, for the visual code-free capabilities that we added, we have enhanced monitoring capabilities where we can tell you for every step how much data came in, how much data went out, partitioning information, kurtosis, all of that is available for you to look at.
So much more powerful than it was even just a few years ago.
Yes, and one of the things that we are doing is we are adding patterns, inbuilt patterns to this code-free capability, right? What that means is that, for example, for this one, right? Like if I were to show you this particular data flow, and here, if you want to use complex partitioning schemes like round robin and all of that, so it's just a choice that you make. You just do a selection over here, and again, we are doing all those heavy lifting, and you can do that this in few simple clicks.
Yep.
Also, for data, we are enabling things like schema drift, right? As you can see in data integration world, you could have more columns coming in the source, but you don't want your data integration pipelines to get affected. So all of that is supported out of the box with this newly added capability.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
So people just get this. This is like, once again, we've talked about this before when we've had you on. that they don't have to click anything, they don't have to upgrade, they just visit Azure Data Factory and it just keeps getting better.
Yes, and this is available today in public preview. They can essentially go use it, play with it, give us feedback, and work with it, right? So, and also with this pattern, just for completeness, once the data is in the DW, now you could have Power BI dashboards hooked up to it, right? Mm-hmm. So here I have a Power BI dashboard where I'm looking at the sales trends.
Awesome.
And this is running on a refresh, hooked up to that data warehouse, which where my pipeline runs every day. It uploads my star schema in the data warehouse, and this Power BI dashboard is hooked up to it so that I can gain those intelligent insights so that the business decision makers can take a look at it and make decisions based on it.
Fantastic. Always impressive. I always appreciate you coming on the show. Yeah. I'm learning how to ingest, prep, transform, and load data warehouses code-free.
Yes.
At scale with Azure Data Factory Data Flow. I'm learning all about it today on Azure Friday.